Welcome to another video on the Titanic Solution series using Excel and Python. In this particular series, we're going to be using H2O to run our model and see what the submission score is going to be looking like on the leaderboard. So let's get started. If you don't have H2O, you need to install H2O. For that, you need to be installing Java V13 and or below. And then you're going to also install the H2O. Check out the latest version or release whenever possible and use the pip install even if you're using a Anaconda distribution. So once you have H2O set up, what we're going to do is we're going to begin by importing the libraries first. So we're going to import pandas and numpy, also H2O, and in this particular example we'll use the H2O gradient boosting estimator. Along with it, we are going to get the evaluation packages, that is metric and ROCAUC score. So once we import the libraries, what we'll do is we'll initiate H2O, and this takes quite some time to do so. And you'll know once it's ready, when you're able to access this link and see a H2O flow interface where you could do visual machine learning. So I'm going to click on this particular link and see what H2O flow platform looks like. You have the sequence for you to build the machine learning flows, but we're going to explore this particular interface in another video. For now, we're just going to use it in the Jupyter notebook. So once this is initiated, you'll see all of these details are available. We're just going to ignore this particular thing for now and then move on directly to import the train and test data set. So I'm going to read the train and test data set provided by Kaggle and check for missing values. Obviously, there are some missing values in both these data sets. So what we'll do is we'll just do a quick treatment. We're going to concatenate both train and test data set and treat missing values in one go. So if I do that, you'll see that you'll have missing values here. And this is how we're going to be treating the missing values. We're going to fill age with median, fair with median. Embarked, we're just going to fill the mode of it. Then age, we're going to bin it into five buckets. And then with cabin, we're just going to fill missing because there are a lot of other missing values, and just take the first string of it so that we just get reduced number of categories. Then we're going to create some more features like family size is alone. And what we're going to do is, and also create another variable from the name variable calling it title. We're just going to extract the titles from the name, and this is what it's going to be looking like. But since there are so many categories, what we're going to do is we're going to reduce them to a manageable chunk. And then what we'll do is we'll delete the unwanted variables and have the crisp variable that we're going to be using for modeling. Now we'll also do the dummy variable creations on all of these variables that we created. And next, this is the part where we are entering the H2O modeling phase. In this particular example, what we'll have to do now is that the train and test data set that we created, we'll have to convert them to a H2O frame. For that, we'll take H2O.H2O frame. Now within this, it takes in the data set, and we're going to take the ones that are not NA for the train data set, and wherever there is NA, we're going to be taking that as a test data set. So this is how train and test got converted to a H2O frame. Next, we'll have to divide the data into train and test split. And in H2O, we also do a validation split also. So in this particular example, what we're going to do is we're going to take the variable name as opposed to train test split, where we give the actual data. Here, we're just going to give the column names for it to do the train test and split. So we're going to take the variable names, and you'll see I've taken the target variable and predictor variables in another variable. So now let's divide it into train, validation and test. In this particular example, the way H2O operates, it's that it builds the model on the train data sets and validates or tries to improve the score using the validation data set. So that's why it's a little different from the train test split that we usually do using sklearn. In this particular example, we're going to create the train, validation and test data frame, and the ratios we'll be giving is such as this, right? So we're going to say 0.7 and 0.15, which means the remainder will be the test data set. And we're going to give seed of 2018, which is very similar to the random state in sklearn packages. So let's run this particular code. And now let's first get the rows or the data into the target variable. So now we got all the target variables first, and now we are ready to build the model. So for it, we'll look at the predictors. Our predictors is obviously going to be these variables that we created dummy variables of, and then we're going to declare an instance of H2O gradient boosting estimator, and we don't need to give anything as such now, but we can give hyperparameters obviously for this. But for this particular example, we're just going to use the plain vanilla one. For the training, what we'll need to give is the X variables that we have, that is the predictors, and the Y variable, that is the target, that is survive. And the training frame is going to be train underscore DF. So remember, we divided into train DF, valid DF, and test DF. We're going to give train DF as this particular data here. Now, we're going to run this particular model and build the model. Now, it takes some time to run. So the next thing that we will do is we will take the test data frame and then predict on that particular data set and see how our prediction is looking like. So I created this, and this is what it's going to be looking like. Take some time to predict. Then we're going to check the accuracy. First, the train accuracy. Ran it, and then we got the predictions. Sorry, it takes some time to execute it. And then when we want to check the accuracy, we run it, and then we'll get the prediction AUC for this particular example. So we have the train prediction value compared against the true train validation. You'll notice that we'll get an AUC score of 0.915, which seems to be a little overfitted. But now let's run the test accuracy and see what's the test accuracy looking like. So if I run this particular code, you'll see that the test accuracy is 0.81, and as rightly said, it's very far off. Obviously, this is not a good state of model to be in, but let's just go ahead and submit the solution to Kaggle and see how it benchmarks against the other submissions that we have done in this particular series. So for this thing, what we're going to do is we're going to take for all the test data set that Kaggle provided, and we're going to be predicting using the model that we built. So we'll predict it, and then we'll convert it as a data frame. Now what we can do is we can combine the passenger ID and the survived final prediction together and see it in a particular data set. With H2O, it takes some time to run. Obviously, you have, if you have GPUs or TPUs running at the backend, this is all going to be a lot faster. So you do that, and then we have a final data frame ready. If I run this, this is going to export our submission file to a drive where I can then upload it to Kaggle. So I've uploaded it to Kaggle, and seems it's taking time to get the submission. Yeah, it's submitted, and you can see that basically I have a 0.78 score, which is slightly above the average of the base models that we have built in the previous examples. So definitely a good place to start with. Obviously, with the hyperparameters using the H2O, we are going to be able to perform much more better than this score, and already the score is doing much more better than the average that we already have among all the other examples that we did. So this is how you use H2O, which is a non-SQLearn package, to run a machine learning model and then predict and make a submission on Kaggle. The next video, what we'll try to do is do the auto H2O part of it and see how that particular model benchmarks against the auto ML code that we ran using Teapot. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.